So my question is that when Papa answered the question that they can use preservatives, and now there is a there's somebody who also went that God gave a divine revelation, so he went to hell and met some people with preservatives in their hands, and God warned. God told him to come back to the earth and warn people that they should not use preservatives like condoms and so on. And now, because there's a, it's a way that young boys and girls are using to do fornication so that they will not get pregnant, and they're using preservatives. Now, God is angry with the preservatives. So what? How do we put this together?
Now, don't ever say a man speaking by revelation is speaking by God until you can find that message in the scripture. Don't ever say a person who rises up from dream and is telling you dream that he met with God, actually met with God, until you can verify that message from the scripture. Don't ever agree that a person said God told him something and he gave you the message and you cannot find that message in the Bible. God has no word to give except what is in the Bible. Don't allow those poor boys in Togo. Don't allow those poor boys in Togo. Don't allow those poor boys in Togo to be confusing you. They don't understand the scriptures. To be confusing you. They don't understand the scriptures. To be confusing you. They don't understand the scriptures. And Satan takes advantage of them. Satan takes advantage of them to spoil the church of God. Can you find that message in the scripture? Can you find what they are saying in the Bible?
So they use Genesis chapter 38, the case of Onan who refused to impregnate the wife of the brother. So he was spear on the ground.
Can you now see people who have no knowledge of scripture? Can you now see people who have no knowledge of scripture? Can you now see people who have no knowledge of scripture? Can you now see people who have no knowledge of scripture? See how they are quoting the scripture and misusing it. They have no knowledge. Is that because they were using contraceptives? No. Onan did that in total rebellion against God because he didn't want to show love to his late brother. That was why God judged him. Not because he did withdrawal and spilled it outside. Not because he did withdrawal and spilled it outside. Not because he did withdrawal and spilled it outside. Not because he did withdrawal and spilled it outside. No. It's because of the wicked spirit he had. No. It's because of the wicked spirit he had. No. It's because of the wicked spirit he had. Those boys are too small to speak about the scripture. What do they even know? Those boys are too small to speak about the scripture. What do they even know? Those boys are too small to speak about the scripture. What do they even know? Those boys are too small to speak about the scripture. What do they even know? Those boys are too small to speak about the scripture. What do they even know? Those boys are too small to speak about the scripture. What do they even know? Those boys are too small to speak about the scripture. What do they even know? What do they know? You came from Catholic Church and the Lord gave you revelation. The Lord directed him to see me. The Lord directed him to see me. The Lord directed him to see me. Go and see my servant, Pastor Rica. I saw a lady condemned in heaven. I saw people holding condom. I said, yes. The unmarried people using condom are sinners. Condom then becomes an instrument of illicit sex. They're not married. They have no right to use it. But the people who are married have right to it. The people who are married have right to it. The people who are married have right to it. The people who are married have right to it. Do they know Bible? 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 They want to be teachers to control the church. Can God carry the church and give to children? They want to be teachers to control the church. Can God carry the church and give to children? They want to be teachers to control the church. Can God carry the church and give to children? Woe to that nation whose king is a child. Woe to that nation whose king is a child. Can God carry the church and give to a child? Can God carry the church and give to a child? Can God carry the church and give to a child? Does the novice have the right to pastor? Does the novice have the right to pastor? Does the novice have the right to pastor? How long have they been in Christ? How long have they been in Christ? How long have they been in Christ? Let's not allow them to destroy people. They don't know what they are saying. They want to be teachers of show. We meet with Jesus. We saw Jesus. Were you there? When they met with Jesus, were you there? Were you standing there?
My second question goes thus. Concerning family planning, is it right for a couple to use maybe pills for the wife not to be pregnant or to be injected so that pregnancy will not?
It's still the same problem of those boys. There are some people in Togo that claim authority in divine revelation. Since they have internet as a free place. They carry these things there into the internet. And they tell them that God says he has forsaken me because I am teaching people that they should use family planning meetups. They carry these things there into the internet. And they tell them that God says he has forsaken me because I am teaching people that they should use family planning meetups. They carry these things there into the internet. And they tell them that God says he has forsaken me because I am teaching people that they should use family planning meetups. They carry these things there into the internet. And they tell them that God says he has forsaken me because I am teaching people that they should use family planning meetups. And I am saying, do they know the Lord? Go and check whether they are righteous. Go and check. The Lord sent you come, and I instructed you, this is it. You refuse to obey what I said. To obey what I said. What Bible do you know? You came from Catholic Church. And you are not literate. Let's be very careful so that they don't affect us.
Is it right that when a couple they're on the bed, for the man or for the woman to go up?
This is Togo doctrine. It's Togo doctrine. It's Togo doctrine. It's Togo doctrine. It's Togo doctrine. Togo. There is a demon in 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 Togo.
So my reason for these questions is because these are the things that are bringing a lot of confusion in Togo.
Yeah, for long. In fact, almost about 1 year now. So we have been hearing it now.
So if you can really give us, in fact, tell us what to do so that we go and answer them, give them the right answers. So it will also help us a lot in Togo.
It's a few sect of people that allow a demon spirit to come and take over their lives. Are we people understanding? It's like a serious... because I've been hearing of these people for too long, and they're doing damage. The Lord told him to come, and he refused. I told him what is right. He said, no. The Lord told him to come, and he refused. I told him what is right. He said, no, he doesn't want it. No. What have you even known? The Lord told him to come, and he refused. I told him what is right. He said, no, he doesn't want it. No. What have you even known? The Lord told him to come, and he refused. I told him what is right. He said, no, he doesn't want it. No. What have you even known? He doesn't want it. No. What have you even known? Elves have no authority to teach. Elves have no authority to teach. Elves have no authority to teach. Scriptures. They don't know it. Scriptures. They don't know it. They should serve under masters. Novices should serve under masters until they learn to full age. They should serve under masters. Novices should serve under masters until they learn to full age. They should serve under masters. Novices should serve under masters until they learn to full age. They should serve under masters. Novices should serve under masters until they learn to full age. So all this thing, a woman should not be on top of her husband. Nonsense, we call them so. Nonsense, we call them so. Nonsense, we call them so. So all this thing, a woman should not be on top of her husband. Nonsense, we call them so. Nonsense, we call them so. Nonsense, we call them so. They should serve under masters. Novices should serve under masters until they learn to full age. Just like that. I say it's revelation. It's not from God. Thank you.
Excuse me, I don't know why it is biblical. Is it right that married couple can make it a condom? Maybe I had you wrong.
Which way are you confused? In which area?
That a married couple prevention measure.
Yes.
That they do take.
Okay.
Yes. That married couple can use condom.
Okay.
Is that biblical? Is that right? Because Genesis says God blessed us to go and multiply. And now, if we, man now, in his own wisdom, stopping the children that are to come forth, maybe 10 and 2 only we've given. Is that biblical? Is that right? Is that no sin? I feel I should know that. Thank you, sir. Because the world is almost taking up to this, and there is always prevention.
I can see you have beard. Do you normally have beard? Ask them a beard. Give him the microphone, my brother. Do you normally have beard?
I am of the age. Now I have them.
Do they grow more than what I'm seeing now?
They do.
What do you do when they are growing the way you don't want?
I do trim them.
Are you not committing sin? Get to what I'm saying. Because the beard is given to you by God.
Yes.
Are you not committing sin for not allowing them to grow to full length?
For they are not. They are not human. So I trim them.
They're not normal.
They're not human beings.
What? No, I mean they're living things. The hair is a living thing.
They are not breathing.
Who told you?
No. Stopping children coming from.
No, I'm talking about the beard of your beard. Who told the beard and living things? I mean, God, how did they come? Is it not natural?
Sir, but the question is.
Listen.
Did they write that you do that?
Wait, I'm coming. Is it not natural that this beard come to you?
Really?
Where do you cut short them?
Why?
Where do you trim them?
Getting too bushy.
It's getting too bushy.
Yes.
The other man says getting too much children he cannot control because he doesn't have the money. That is why he could control, cut off the number of children he has so that it can be convenient for him.
And Paul Rica said, thank you. It's terrible. It's just the beginning. We are going to start talking. Thank you, brothers. I always say that if you are on the way of somebody and the person starts going out of the road, you have to do everything to bring him back. But if he don't want to understand and listen to you, you have to take your position and to separate yourself from him and start praying for him. But if you want to continue with him blindly, you are going to end like him, because the Bible says that a blind man cannot lead a blind man. All of you who are listening to me now and Paul Rica, I'm going to ask him a question. Those who have six children, question to Pastor Paul Rica. Those who have six children, and in the time of recession now, the time of crisis, can the person use poison to eradicate or to reduce the number of the children that he have, so that he can have the number of the children that he can feed? If he did that, it's not a sin. You are saying that Gabriel is a poor and illiterate. And Pastor Paul Rica, are you rich? Are you illiterate? The Lord Jesus, when he was on earth here, do you want to university? Do he have a master? What is making a difference between him and the doctor of the law? The spirit of the Lord, the knowledge of this war. The Bible says that the spirit of the war, the spirit of the law is upon me. That said, Jesus, you have said that Gabriel is from Catholic Church. I'm going to ask you a question. And your wife Linda, where is she from? Can you tell us, Paul Rica, is there a difference between the origin of your wife and Gabriel? Your wife also was saying that she was Christian by going to church, but she was living totally in fornication. Gabriel also was saying that he was a Christian, but he was living totally in a sin and was going to hell. But the grace of the Lord, he bring them to himself. Tell me, what is the difference between the power that the Lord bring your wife from and Gabriel from? The Lord said that he can take all those things who are insignificant, all those things who are little, to make a confusion, to confuse all those things who are biggest, like the example of the King David. Is King Saul and his army who kill Goliath? Is David was literate? Is David was in army school? If it's yes, tell us which kind of military school. Is it true the advice of state of army of King Saul that David killed Goliath? Tell us. Or on the revelation of the law that the Lord has given to him. When David was going to Goliath with the armor that King Saul has given to him, he saw that it was not useful for him because he said that he never used those armors. He threw them away. Is he a specialist in shooting in Israel? If David used the advice of Saul by killing David, will not Saul will take the glory of the law? See, after the victory of David on Goliath, is not on the power of flesh, but through the spirit of the Lord that he killed Goliath. See how King Saul hates David because he was thinking that David will take his glory. When the Lord Jesus was also telling a Pharisees people and the doctor of the law, they didn't want to listen to him because they are looking him as illiterate. They are looking him that he's from Mary and Joseph. They don't want to listen to him, and they are thinking that the Lord Jesus will take their glory. The glory that the people are giving to them. They will not have their place in the country again. So King Saul was fighting David, but it's not David that he was fighting, but the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. And we'll see how King Saul finished his life. Tell us, read this passage, Isaiah 56, verse 9. Do you know the plan of the Lord upon the life of somebody? If your mother was using planning parenthood or your father was using condoms, will you be born today and to be a leader of Oromo in Nigeria today? Tell us. Will you be there today? Who will know you? Don't be a moderate Obama for the church, because they agree with abolition. They agree with planning parenthood. Maybe you say that you are not for abolition, but you are from you are for planning parenthood, contraception. All those practices are using to kill babies before they are born. I want to talk to you now for the plan that the leaders of this world are preparing to reduce the number of the people all around the world. I'm going to tell you about all those things that you can locate yourself. They are doing all those things to bring people to hell. I'm talking to you about President Obama. They agree with abolition. Do you know what means planning parenthood? Do you know what they are doing? Go and do the research. Do you know how many children are dying a day in the whole world through abortion, through planning parenthood? Do you know? Do you know the origin of Planned Parenthood? Do you know why they bring distance in the world? It's to reduce the number of of people around the world. The will of the law is to allow people to come on earth, and through those people, they can use them to break the plan of devil Satan. But the devil don't want that people come in this earth. For example, I'm going to give you the example of Moses. Do you know how many people died when Moses was born? Do you know how many people were died when the Lord Jesus come on this earth? Because they want to kill him, and they kill people, a lot of children in Israel, and they kill a lot of people in Egypt when Moses was born. Do you know that? It to avoid the plan of the Lord to be accomplished in this war. Because he know that the Caleb's, Joshua's, who will come on this earth to destroy all his plans. To destroy all his plans. And he's doing all those things to avoid the plan of the Lord to be accomplished. If everybody were using condoms, contraception, who will be banned? Who will come on this earth, Paul Rica? I'm asking you the question. If they are using injection, who will come in this on this earth? Tell us. One day we will see that there will no be any person on this earth. The Freemason, the Illuminati of this world, they want to kill people through all those systems. I will tell you something now. The law that they are bringing on this earth, the law, is Mary, the mother of Jesus, use condoms after the birth of Jesus, so that the brothers of Jesus will not come on this earth? Did she use that? And the mother of John Baptist, or Sarai, the wife of Abraham, or Anna, the mother of Samuel, did Esther did that? Did Ruth do that? Paul Rica, think. Look. You are talking about the case of honor with a flesh answer. You are saying that it is a bad spirit inside the home or owner who make that the Lord kill him. Let us know, where is it right in the Bible? Let us know. Tell us. That is a bad spirit inside of him. I'm going to tell that it's a theological answer. It's a theological answer. We don't need the interpretation of Darwin or evolutionism. But the war is not the obligation of owner to sleep with Tamar, the wife of his brother who died. It's not an obligation for owner to have a progeny with Tamar. He have a choice to refuse or to accept. But by saying no, they have to bring owner and Tamar to the chief of the law authority of so that owner can say that in public, that he don't want to have children with Tamar. That and this time they can say something, some words, people will cry on him, so that Tamar will be free to marry, to get married. You see, it's what the Bible is saying. It's how it's passing in Israel at that time. But owner refused. But he want to have a profit to sleep with Tamar, avoiding to have children with her by using the abomination system by throwing a sperm on earth. The Bible says that there is nothing new on this earth. All those things exist before. Condoms exist before. In Egypt, people were using the intestine of a pig to do condoms. They are using, see, all those things, they are using them. Those things exist before. The women were using clay. They are cleaning their sex with clay so that if the sperm enter their vagina, the argile, the clay will cut all the sperm. You see? All those things that exist before, see all those signs that the prostitutes. When we were in a village, our brothers, also senior brothers, were using all those kind of things. Before to sleep with a woman, they have to go to drink alcohol with some product so that they cannot ejaculate when they are sleeping with a woman. See. All those things exist before. See. They exist before. See. Those who don't have money, what are they doing? When they are sleeping with a woman, they cut their breath. When they sperm, when they want to ejaculate, they cut their breath so that they cannot ejaculate. You see, all those kind of the system exist before. And I can tell you about the older system again. But we are not teaching people to use all those 10 things, but to tell you that all those things exist before. Ona also know that things. It is the reason why he is putting his sperm on earth. If Ona saw condom at that time, I'm going to ask you a question. If Ona was using, was have an opportunity to have condom, will he not use condom at that time? And if he used condoms, will God will not kill Ona? See, all those things exist before. There is no bad spirit or spirit in Ona because Ona want to have a sex with Tamar without have children with him in secret. But he don't want to declare it, and he's sleeping. He's sleeping with Tamar in profit. By through a demoniac or through an abomination system, the sex it's the reason why today people are using condoms everywhere. They are using Planned Parenthood everywhere today. Children, young boy, young girl. Pastor Rica, do you hear me? The young girl, 10 years, they have all those things inside their vagina. And you are for that. Do you know all havoc that all those things are bringing all around the world? Do you know the havoc? Eh? Adultery, prostitution. Do you know all those things? Do you know what they are bringing? The havoc that they are bringing in the world today. That those things are bringing promotion of sexuality, of abortion, of all those kind of things. Eh? And all those people who are doing all those things, where are they going? Oh, they are going to hell. Let me ask you a question again. John Baptist, can you tell us the Bible school that he went, all the disciples of Jesus? Do you know the theologic way? Do you know where they are, the theologic school that they have gone? Can you tell us? It's the reason why the doctor, the priests are calling them, the Pharisees are calling them a foolish boy. It's like this, that they are calling them because the spirit of the law was using them. But they are not using by the spirit of the law, but they are using the knowledge of human knowledge. Eh? In the book of Acts 4:15-20, they are avoiding them to do not speak in the name of the law. But they say that they cannot stop. They have to do the will of the law. That all those things that they have seen, they have talked about them. Nobody cannot stop them to say all those things. That is not good for them to do the will of the man. to judge that themselves, if it's good for them to do the will of God or to do the will of men. The apostle, they didn't do that. And do you want Gabriel to do that? If the apostle did that to that day, will you hear about them today? The words are created to be used, the words. But one day the Lord used a word to talk to Balaam, because he don't want to understand the voice of the Lord, that the Lord was passing through Balak to talk to him, to not curse the Israel people. And Gabriel, that the Lord took from a Catholic church, who have valor in front of people and in front of God, the words of a man like Gabriel. Tell us, God is sovereign. He can use anyone to talk to anyone. He can do anything in any way. You cannot teach him. His way is not your way. It's not you to tell him what to do. He can do anything he wants to do. He can pass through anybody, even animals, even children. He can pass through them to talk to us. Let us be, maybe you are in a farm, in the bush, with chicken. If the serpent is coming or snake is coming through you, if the chicken, the snake, they will start crying, croak, 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 so that you can know that something is going wrong. The Lord give them those capacities. In Africa, you see how there are some animals who are crying, who in the morning, like a chicken, they can cry to give us a signal. That is the day. The Lord is sovereign. That is the day. He can do anything when he wants, how he wants to do it. If the Lord wants to use those people who have knowledge, who are rich, he will not use your wife to talk to the church today or to talk to the world today. Who is your wife, Linda? Tell me. If God wants to use those people, your wife is nothing in front of those people. He will pass through Bill Gates or those people who are ready to talk to the world. But he used your wife. He used your wife. Your wife is nothing, but he used him. People was criticizing your wife, and all we are against all those things. Now today you start preaching all the same things. Where is the difference between you and those people who were insulting your wife, Linda? Tell us. You said that to avoid to use planning parenthood is the doctrine of Togo. And you are saying that all those doctrines are from Togo. You have to know that in the world there is an association. They are fighting against planning parenthood. When planning parenthood come on this earth, people were against planning parenthood. People were against it. They are continue fighting. Still, the first generation passed. Those people who were fighting, some of them died. Some of them went to prison because of planning parent. Go and do the research. People went to prison because of planning parenthood. And today you are supporting them. Even Vatican, Italy, Catholic Church, some popes are against. Some priests are against. What is the difference between those people, parenthood, and you? Eh? Look around you. Look. Is you to kill them before they come? They have to come in on this earth. It's not the doctrine of Togo. Oh, doctrine of Nigeria, of Congo, or of America. Let us see the case of Adam and Eve. The Lord told them to go to procreate, to multiply on earth. It's you to avoid the will of God. How many people are on this earth? Go and do the research. We have lands everywhere. All those ideologies are satanic. Excuse me. God is sovereign. He gave an exceptional characteristic to a woman so that the woman have a menstruation periods or menopause time. That means certain time, she's an impossibility to conceive or to give birth. Like a 14 year, a woman who have a 27 year or 20, 30 year before to get married. Three children, she is already on menopause. The animals don't have those problems. Sex. The woman been have those problems. I elevate. Let me give you an example of hares or any other animals. If the female of animal is not in the time of one time, they will never accept the male to claim them or to have sex with them. Cats, dogs, they are living like the Lord created them. It's the human being who have those problems. There is a brother who asked you a question about condoms by couples. Because there were a woman from Cameroon who asked a question that there were a man who have IDs and her wife, the wife don't have IDs. You give a demoniac answer, telling them to use condoms or protection. If you don't have any answer to give to people, close your mouth. Close your mouth. It's clear. And Paul Riga told her to use protection. Paul Riga was telling this guy also to asking this boy if his beer are going bush, what he's doing with the beer. The guy said that he have to call them if they are going bush. Paul Riga is giving a comparison between he's saying that beers and children are equal. It's what we are saying. Huh? Can we compare beers and children? And the brother was telling him that beers don't have breath. And he said, why he said that the beers don't have breath? It's terrible, brothers and sisters. Beers. And me, I think that he will stop there. He said, thank you. Oh, the brother also said, okay, thank you. God bless you. And he make the brother make a sign. Okay, I say what I can say. Okay, you want to that you want is what we are saying. Okay, see what the brother is doing. Yes, you want to say what you want to say. Okay, it's what you say. Can you compare BS to children? Can a man go to advise God in matter of procreation? Isaiah 56 verse 9. Read there to see. You cannot avoid the plan of God. Read there. Let him hear what Bill Gates is saying. They are thinking in the name of Clement and a new world, ecologic world, to see if there is a difference between what Bill Gates is saying and what Paul Riga is saying. Listen.
CO2 is warming the planet. And the equation on CO2 is actually a very straightforward one. If you sum up the CO2 that gets emitted, that leads to a temperature increase. And that temperature increase leads to some very negative effects. The effects on the weather, perhaps worse, the indirect effects in that the natural ecosystems can't adjust to these rapid changes, and so you get ecosystem collapses. Now, the exact amount of how you map from a certain increase in CO2 to what temperature will be and where the positive feedbacks are, there's some uncertainty there, but not very much. And there's certainly uncertainty about how bad those effects will be, but they will be extremely bad. I asked the top scientists on this several times, do we really have to get down to near zero? Can't we just, you know, cut it in half or a quarter? And the answer is that until we get near to zero, the temperature will continue to rise. And so that's a big challenge. It's very different than saying, you know, we're a 12-foot high truck trying to get under a 10-foot bridge and we can just sort of squeeze under. This is something that has to get to zero. Now, we put out a lot of carbon dioxide every year, over 26 billion tons. For each American, it's about 20 tons. For people in poor countries, it's less than one ton. It's an average of about 5 tons for everyone on the planet. And somehow we have to make changes that will bring that down to zero. It's been constantly going up. It's only various economic changes that have even flattened it at all. So we have to go from rapidly rising to falling and falling all the way to zero. This equation has four factors, a little bit of multiplication. So you've got a thing on the left, CO2, that you want to get to zero. And that's going to be based on the number of people, the services each person's using on average, the energy on average for each service, and the CO2 being put out per unit of energy. So let's look at each one of these and see how we can get this down to zero. Probably one of these numbers is going to have to get pretty near to zero. Now, that's back from high school algebra. But let's take a look. First, we've got population. The world today has 6.8 billion people. That's headed up to about 9 billion. Now, if we do a really great job on new vaccines, healthcare, reproductive health services, we could lower that by perhaps 10 or 15%. But there we see an increase of about 1.3.
The governments of this world, they have a law now, but was not already voted in the name of climate, ecology. They are calling that the rights of procreation. That means before you give birth, you have to go to ask permission from authority. They will ask you the reason of why you want to give birth. That if your answer is not correct, they will refuse to you to give birth. They want to reduce the population of the world. That there is a lot of people on this earth, 7 billion. I am calling them the master of this world. They who are making rain, or without them, the world cannot find food to eat. It's like they are gods. You have to know that Planned Parenthood was made to destroy the world. For they are calling them silence armor and free war. See that they are calling that silence armor and free war. some of them are using condoms to avoid the children to be conceived. Some of them, when those children are in the womb of their mother, they are making abortion. And some of them, like Bill Gates now, if some of them are now born, they are using a vaccine to kill them. All those people are working for the devil. They are antichrist. Listen, see. Let me ask you, if the Lord wants to pass through a mother and a father to bring a Samson, a David, a Gideon, a Paul, Pierre, Peter, Caleb, Samuel, Esther, Ruth, Deborah, Sarah, Mary, in this world, if they don't want to pass through them to bring them to this world, and the mother start using a Planned Parenthood, or the father start using condoms, see that saying that they don't have money, they don't want to have children now, they don't want to live their life, they want to do their life like they want. When they will have money, they will start having children. The Lord said that He will provide for us. He's our provider. What is this faith? Our apostles, do they use condoms? Or do they teach to use condoms? Huh? Is the teaching of condoms in the Bible? Tell us. If our God can feed birds, animals, how can't He feed us? Ours, we are made in the image of the law. Don't teach people to limit our God. What are we going to say? The population of China, they have a political for one child. All those Chinese, are they using? Planned Parenthood. They are killing a billion of children a day. Abortion a day. Even families. If even your wife is conceived, you cannot bring her to hospital. You have to kill the child. You have to kill him inside your womb. Where are they going? All those people, Chinese. Where are they going? Hell. Are you going to support all those ideology? Huh? Paul Rica is telling us that a woman can claim his husband. On beds. I don't know if your parents are alive now. Go and ask them in Nigeria. Ask them if those things exist before. They will tell you no, that those things are abomination. There is a shower people who are using all those kind of things. Those things did not exist before. A shower. It's an abomination. Our mothers, before to have to sleep with our fathers, they are ashamed. I don't know what you are thinking. If your wife did that in the world before to come to Christ, don't allow her to teach that distance in the church. If you want to do that with your wife, do it. If you don't want to repent, do it. But don't to push the Christians, the church, to start doing all those things. If you are not agree with me, maybe the animals of Nigeria, they will speak to you. The animals of Nigeria will give you the answer. They will tell you that it's wrong with that the kitchen, the cow. They will tell you that they are not doing all those things. That the females are not claiming the male, that every time it's the male who are claiming the female. The Bible said that Adam knew Eve. It's not Eve who knew Adam's. It's Adam who knew Eve, and not Eve who knew Adam's. Imagine that your wife is on top of you. The sperm, when you are going to make ejaculation, where will be good the sperm? We have to say that. We have to show those things. We have to tell people to know all those things, that they have to know what Paul Rica is saying. Huh? All those things are damaged. You have to, we have to show them. You have to know the church to know. You are telling us in Proverbs 22 or 12 that the Lord said to go to fetch water and to fetch water. It's always the every time is the basket who is going inside the well. It's not the well inside the basket. It's always the basket who is going to the well and not the well to the basket. If you see that in Nigeria, that the well is going to the basket, all the Nigeria chains, the medias, they will come there. The animals don't have those problems. Thank Jesus, because he came to show us all those things, those revelations, so that we can repent. And you are saying that where is all those things in the Bible? In the Bible, do you can see that the makeup is the blood that the witch and the satanists are collecting to make a nail polish and makeup for us? You cannot see that in the Bible. That is a contradiction. All those things are coming from pornography shops. Today we can call that the technology, sex technology. I can call it like this, sex technology. Is today you have the star of pornography stars. You can see five people to have a sex together. This one took the penny, did it like this, ten like this. All those kind of things. All those things are in the same bag. They are in the same bag. They have the same origin. They are the same things. Is that? When we was in the secondary school, they are teaching us all those things. Those practice, those position, animal position, back, something like this, all those things. And we are looking at all those things as a new things. We want to have a curiosity. Some people want to have curiosity to go to do that, to see how is it. Because we know that it's always a man who is claiming a woman. But when we are seeing all those things, it's like a curiosity for us. People want to do that. They want to do that. I can call that sex aberration. Sex a mistake. No matter the deepness of the well, it's always the basket who is going to the well to go to fetch water. It's not the well who is going to the basket. If you see that one day, that you do not have to know that it's abomination. I'm going to give some scripture to our sister and brothers who are listening to us tonight, to do not follow a man. Let us pray for Paul Rica, so that the spirit of pornography, this spirit can leave him, so that he can preach the true gospel. To do not add anything. Deuteronomy 18:22. Say that if a prophet prophesies and it's not come, it's a lie. Your team, Oremos, they say that Jonathan Goodluck will be a president. Is it come? No. Jonathan Goodluck has gone. You have to know that it's not the Lord who speaks through your wife or this the person who prophesies. What do you see? Pharisean people are calling Jesus a Beelzebul. The Lord told them, you saw all those things I have done with your children. I healed them. The blind are seeing. Those who are dampo, they are listening. People are real. But they continue calling Jesus Beelzebul. If we are saying that Gabriel is have a demon in him, there is a demon who is using him. Gabriel told you that you are going to marry your wife. You reject that. But because of the Lord who speak, it's common. If you can call Gabriel Beelzebul, is the Beelzebul, this Beelzebul spirit who speak to you? So you listen to the voice of Beelzebul. But it's God who speak, and it come. Let us read 1 John 4, 1 to 5. Brother, don't fool a man. Don't fool a man. All those spirits who are not confessed Jesus, that is from God, is not from God. Those spirits are not from God. Let us continue to 5. If you have your English Bible, you can read it. I don't have English Bible. It's the reason why I have silence. Those one who are from God will listen to what we are saying. But if somebody is not from God, he will reject what we are saying. There is a woman from Cameroon who asked this question about a woman and a man who have IDs and her wife don't have IDs. And Paul Rica was telling her to use protection. Brothers, where is Jesus in all those things? Our Lord who can heal, cannot heal this man. That woman was with his husband for a lot of time. They don't know that the man have IDs. But the protection of the law is already on the woman. Why to tell a woman again to go to where a contraception? Why do not to tell a woman to tell the man to give his life to Jesus, or to a man if he is a Christian, to pray so that the Lord can heal the man? The healing or the condoms? A question. Between the healing, the prayer, the healing, and the condom, what are we going to choose as a Christian? Are you going to choose condoms or the healing? If the condom is over, the healing of Jesus or the power of Jesus, judge it yourself. People are laughing, they are clapping. They are in a mistake. Let us pray for Paul Rica. People are clapping him. Let us read Ephesians 5:11. We have to separate ourselves from the darkness purpose. It's what the Bible is telling us, and not to support them. We condemn all those practices, all those things that people who are following Paul Rica have to turn back, and Paul Rica also has to turn back. People who are calling him daddy, 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 master, 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 master. And you are not telling him anything. You are following him blindly like this. He don't want to go. He don't want to enter the kingdom. And he don't want to allow people also to enter. All those things can bring people to hell. If somebody want to correct him about all those things, he will put this person apart, or to send him away from Omoro or Remo. My prayer for him is to not him to try to stop the fire that the Lord have already bringing to the church. The Lord want to use again people, children of 8 years, 10 years. He want to bring them to his farm to work for him in this last day. those people who are saying that they are enemies, minister for a lot of time, minister for 20 time, 30 time, 14 years, for 13 years. To stop saying all those things. I'm calling those people, brother and sister, don't fix yourself on pastor. Don't base your faith on pastor. The pastor of the word of God, the pastor of Jesus. Don't say the pastor said that. The pastor, what said the Bible? Read your Bible. What is said the Bible? If he don't want to understand, if he continue to teach the first teach doctrine, leave him and start praying for him. And do not continue following him. The Bible said in John 8:32 that you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. The Bible didn't say that you will know a man, and the man will set you free. And the Bible says, continue to tell us to do not add anything to the word of God. Let us read Deuteronomy 18:21-22. Deuteronomy 18, verses 21 to 22. Read there. You will know what the Bible is saying there. According to people who are giving the prophecies, and those prophecies are not coming on. Don't fear them to tell them the truth. That's what the Bible is saying there. Read your Bible. Are just giving interpretation. What are you saying about the professor of your wife concerning the good luck? And what are you saying about her? We are not fighting you, but we are bringing you to the reality. To the word of God, to do not be pride. Matthew 42:44, let us read there. If you accept or you do not accept today, the day will come that you accept this word that they are giving to you. Let us read something in Revelation 3:16 to 17. Let us read Revelation 3:16 to 17. Let us see what the Bible is saying there. Let us read also Mark chapter 3. 29. Let us read also Isaiah 55, Genesis 35:8-9. Let us read Leviticus 18:19. All those scriptures are going to Pastor Paul Rica. He has said that Gabriel is poor. The Lord is telling you to go and seek his face, to ask him to buy a collar to put inside your eyes so that you can see very well. So that your nakedness cannot be found, and do not to stay on a flesh to teach. The Bible says that the knowledge is of this world is nothing. So ask the knowledge of the law. We are going to end here. So we can meet another time. Let us follow the word, the law. If you find some videos like this that you are seeing that there is some mistake, let us know. We are sisters and brothers. We are fighting to go to heaven. don't allow somebody to bring us back. You want to go forward, but if somebody wants to bring us back, you have to act to say no. He said that people who are said that they have revelation. Who are there? Who saw them? Let me ask a question, Paul Rica, Pastor Paul Rica. When Joseph received revelation from the Lord, his father also was against him, saying that if he also will kneel down for him, if he also will kneel down to him, will his brother also were there when he received the revelation from the Lord? But finally, it come. They bow down to him. I'm not saying that you will bow down to Gabriel. No, or to somebody. But what the Lord say will come. When your wife, Linda, received the revelation, were you there? Were you there, Pastor Paul Rica? When your wife received the revelation, were you there? Let us go give the glory, the honor, the authority to our Lord Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless you abundantly. And see you later. God bless you. Thank you very much. Amen.